Hey, hold on, have a samosa.
I will mentor the best trainee.
I think you'll find that mine will be the better of the two.
Well, make it interesting then. £10 each, right?
Karen, that would be morally corrupt.
Fun, though. And trust me, you're going to want to grab fun where you can now you've got kids.
We're not parenting, Karen.
Well, you're going to tell them what to do and you're going to make sure they do it and you're going to hope like hell that they carry on doing it even when you're not there, which they probably won't. See, you're the mom and you're the dad. Only for the purposes of today's experiment, they won't be tapping you for pocket money. No? Okay.
Come on, let's not compete. All right, let's go stressless.
Good morning,
after all, you need to practice letting things go, don't you?
I need to practice juggling with even more balls.
All right, tell you what, we'll say you're the best if it makes you happy.
We will say I'm the best because I'm the best. Who's the daddy?
Who's the mummy?
No, Daniel, duh. Who's the daddy? As in, who is the daddy? Who is the daddy?
Good morning, Mrs. Holland.
Morning.
Dr. Carmichael?
Freya, I'm glad to see that you're a good timekeeper.
And they're off.
But you're going to have to smarten yourself up a bit before you start work.
Pardon?
As your mentor.
You're my mentor.
I am. And I would rather you were a minute late and better groomed.
Oh, on time. Ali's brushed his hair.
She'll brush her hair.
A very good morning to you, Dr. Tyler.
Not from where I'm standing.
How rude was that? And he looks like he's got terminal dandruff.
Back in the lead.
Look, before you start shouting at me, will you just listen to what I've got to say? Sorry.
Good morning, people.
Ah, good morning, my mentor.
You know, I didn't know whether to go with Mr. Miyagi or just stick with Daniel either. What do you think? What's that?
A friend of mine filmed it on campus last year.
Is that real? That's a nun.
You'll never find a funnier nun clip.
Have you not seen Running with Scissors?
Has it got a nun in it?
Well, it's got a poem about a nun in it. Kevin, have you got any plans this lunchtime?
No, nothing.
Great. Do us a favour.
Of course.
Just I won't get a chance today, and I need the jacket tonight. It's only around the corner. In fact, if you go now, you can get in before kickoff. Won't encroach on your free time.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
You carry on like this, you are a shoo-in for the permanent position.
And the man with the best mangoes in the bouldering? Very dishy.
May I speak to you?
Actually, we were just...
No, it's fine. Of course, you must go before me.
Thank you. Look, my daughter is unwell. I made an appointment for my wife to bring her in to see the doctor. I'm worried there may be something very wrong with her.
Aminata Sisa?
I need to ask you a favor. Please arrange a taxi for them to go home afterward my daughter has been seen. I must be at work. It is not possible for me to stay and take them.
And your wife can't call a cab because...
She doesn't have a mobile phone. If you would allow her to use your telephone, she has a number for a taxi, but I thought you might have people that you use regularly and I thought it might be easier.
I'll make sure she gets home safely.
Thank you very much. I'm very grateful.
Aminata Sese?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. In this
way. You really are a hot little girl, aren't you? How long has she been ill?
For a few days. But I thought it was just something she picked up from the other children. I gave her the baby paracetamol and plenty to drink.
Don't you want to sit down, Aminata? I bet you'd rather be all tucked up snug in bed, wouldn't you? Let's just have a little peek inside your ears.
You see what I mean?
Yes, I do. But skin elasticity isn't really a post-operative concern, is it?
Harvard, I'm the same age as Nigella Lawson. My complexion is excellent because I'm a little bit plump. and I'm the same age as Gillian McKee.
Yes, but not so hard. Weren't we supposed to be keeping an eye on your BMI?
Is your girlfriend very slim, Dr. Granger?
Yes, she is.
And she doesn't cook, does she? My sister's eldest daughter, the science graduate. She's slim, slim, slim. And she can cook, but she's not blessed. How can I put this visually? Are you very much in love with your skinny girlfriend, Dr. Granger?
Delisha. BMI. Ah, that'll be my trainee. Are you sure you don't mind?
No, not at all.
Come in. Dr. Tyler, this is Miss Akram. We were just about to discuss diet and exercise.
Thank you for allowing me to shadow your appointment, Miss Akram.
Delisha. Please call me Delisha.
Are there other children in Amanata's class who are poorly?
She's been away for some time.
Off school?
Yes.
For how long?
Some weeks.
Because she's poorly?
We went on a plane.
Did you? How exciting. And where did you go?
To visit my family.
And where is that, exactly?
Sierra Leone.
Now then, Amanata, I need you to do a little wee for me. Do you think you'll be able to manage that?
Aminata won't be able to make water now.
Don't want to. Mm-hmm.
If you've got naughty germs inside you, I need to be able to fight them.
No. Look, she won't be able to do it. You are upsetting her.
Did I get them?
Excuse me for a moment. Michael, may I see you for a moment?
Excuse me. Sorry about this. I'll just be a minute.
There's an FGM opposition forum.
Staff room.
You have a look of the Mir boys from Sheffield. Do you know them? Their family was originally from Karachi.
No, sorry.
My favorite nephew, Khalik, he has hair as good as yours. He loves my extra special just for my nephew, hot juicy jalebis and my nice and spicy chaat.
That's fine.
Does your mother cook you nice and spicy?
Well, she really wouldn't know where to start.
Ah, good. Modern woman. Next time I'll bring you something, a taste of home. All Pakistani and Indian men love nice and spicy.
Really, don't bother. Not for me.
All respect to your modern mother, but she should cook you the food you love.
I don't love that food.
Forget about the ghee for a minute and enjoy some pakoras.
I never eat ethnic food.
Or my extra specially delicious samosas. Call yourself an Asian man.
No, actually I don't, and I'd rather you didn't either.
I didn't mean...
Bloody samosas. I hate samosas.
That'll do.
No, it's my fault. I never know when to stop. I'm stupid like that. I'm sure your mother doesn't...
And still, you're not stopping.
Enough. Excuse us for a moment, please.
Female genital mutilation. She can't sit down, she's been to Sierra Leone, it all adds up.
You are putting two and two together and coming up with 78.
She's running a fever.
The most probable cause of which is looking likely to be a UTI.
Dr. Carmichael, please. It goes on. It is terrifying for all of the women involved, and the mother she is clearly covering because she's frightened.
You're making a diagnostic leap because you're...
But that kid is scared of passing water. And you should have seen the dad. All smart suit and oppressed wife send his daughter back to the old country to get it cut and sewn. It makes me sick.
No. No, you had the idea first and now you're making everything fit.
The mother's covering.
Okay, am I missing something here?
How would you like it if people thought you were Asian all the time? I'm not Asian.
Hi, how you doing?
Not so good.
Not even going to go there. Whatever. But there are rules governing your behaviour when you're with a patient. First, if for whatever weird reason you think a patient's been rude, you don't snap. You are never sarcastic.
I didn't mean to have a...
And what's that about anyway? I'm not Asian. What are you then?
I might look Asian, but I'm not.
What?
My name's not Abdul. I don't eat samosas. I don't go to the temple or the mosque. My skin is dark. I eat beef, I eat pork, I don't care about Ramadan, and I don't give a stuff about Diwali because I'm not Asian!
Okay, so she accidentally touched a nerve. Get over yourself. It's no excuse for upsetting her.
She made assumptions about...
Delisha Akram would never deliberately offend anyone. You will never behave like that again.
Excuse me, just to let you know that Delisha Akram has left.
I will take her home and put her into bed.
Look, please, Mrs. Sessay, we need to find out what sort of infection your daughter has. If it's a urinary tract infection...
Shall I fetch a potty, Dr. Carmichael?
No, I will take her to the toilet. I will see if she can...
Hold on.
Aminata, what's happening?
She's having a febrile convulsion. It's because her temperature's so high. Aminata!
They made you have Aminata circumcised, didn't they?
Aminata?
Didn't they?
Him. Hey, him! Hey, wake up. You must have heard me. What's wrong, Lillian?
Nothing. Stop it. I've told you there's nothing wrong.
Well, look, I haven't got time to get a coffee now, but why don't we hook up after my shift?
Haven't you got uni stuff?
Yeah, I've got uni stuff. I want to buy you a coffee. Might even stretch your hot chocolate if I make enough tips over lunch.
You have to promise to stop asking me what's wrong, though.
I buy. Get to be big bro. You get me.
Mrs. Lodge?
OK. Well, right, you are then. Friday the 20th, same time. Bye. That was Mrs. Lodge.
She's not here then?
Seems not. All right, how is she? Is everything all right?
We'll see. I'll check her over at St. Phil's.
So who should I get in next, then?
Mr. Waring at 5-2, but he's not here yet.
Right, what do I do now, then?
Actually, some advice. Nurse's room.
Some holidays are the worst. It's estimated that 500 British girls are sent abroad for cutting parties. Because they've got time to heal then, you see, during the school holidays.
Freya.
And, of course, there's the credit crunch. Cutters are actually being brought across into this country to do whole groups of girls at once because it's more economical that way.
Freya.
Of course, it's illegal wherever it happens.
Freya.
What?
Please. I have to call St. Phil's, and they have to examine the genital mutilation on a 6-year-old girl. There's nothing to be so animated about, is there?
Really? He'll be prosecuted.
Who will?
Aminata's father.
It's up to the police to decide who's responsible. Who did it?
Yeah, well, I know. And I was right.
I wish to God you weren't.
How can I help you?
Delicia Akram is a nice woman. She got MRSA.
I have read her notes.
Well, then you'll know that she's a bit of a trooper and very popular around here.
She's a Pakistani woman obsessed with the so-called cuisine of the subcontinent. She clearly eats way too much of it.
You do realise this is me trying to help you out here.
Thank you so much. I'm sure my career would go right down the toilet if it wasn't for you.
You want it down the toilet? You keep that up. What is all this stuff about you not being Asian?
I don't have to explain myself to you.
I'm glad that you are not my son, because he would have more manners.
Well, I'm sure your son's just utterly enchanting.
I bet your mum would be mortified if she knew how rude you are. I feel sorry for a poor woman.
What do you know about my mother? Nothing. So shut your mouth! How dare you?
Oh, I dare. You don't want to see how much I dare. What's wrong with you?
What's wrong with me? I look like something I'm not. I'm genetically unfortunate. That's what's wrong with me.
But what does that mean?
When's the last time someone threw ethnic food at you in the street?
Never.
Really? Me? This morning. What about people moving seats when you get on a train? 9/11, 7/7. Oh, look, an Asian. What's in his backpack? People assume your son's a suicide bomber, do they?
He's a skinny white boy.
Doesn't get a lot of racist insults then.
You mean that doesn't
mean... Scared of fascists, is he? Because he would be if he was me. Your lovely, white-skinned, well-mannered little boy ever been bashed, Mrs. Hollins? Ever taken a beating in the street because of the way he looks? Has he?
What did Delicia Akram do?
She assumed I liked samosas.
What a cow. Honestly, I can't stand by and watch you do crappy things. I want to like you.
I'm sorry.
If you ever tell me to shut my mouth again, I will knock you into the middle of next week.
I'm sorry.
I don't care what the colour of your skin is.
I'm sorry.
Okay. Okay, this is you and me starting again. You may call me Karen.
How are you getting on?
Yeah, fine, you?
Brilliant, then.
You here for your lunch, or you're off out?
Out, I think. Explore, grab a sandwich.
Oh, what, not a samosa?
Careful.
See you later for round two. What? Give me a heart attack!
Oh, do me a favour and make a miserable off-duty copper a coffee, would you?
Okay, you are off the clock. I'm meeting Dr. Granger for lunch. Your time is your own until afternoon surgery.
I get a sandwich, Sam. Well, hello.
Oh, Rob Freya, Freya, Sergeant Hollins.
He's my husband. He's in the police. Hey, why don't we go out for a coffee? I just need to pop for a pee. I've squeezed out my ears.
Finishing school. Worth every penny.
I heard that!
Sorry.
Freya's one of our new trainees.
Oh, if it's a decent butty you're after, there's a good sandwich shop down by the light. It's run by an ex-WPC friend of mine.
I'll give it a try.
Oh, Zara, have you got a minute?
Mm-hmm.
That little girl you sent down to St. Phil's this morning. My lot, I'll need to talk to you about it.
Of course.
It's grim.
Oh, no, I've spoken to the paediatric registrar.
I mean, when you're a kid, you expect your parents to protect you, so what's all that about?
Yeah, well, we're lucky we spotted it. That poor woman.
A parent? Letting it happen, watching someone take a razor to your own little girl.
It's unconscionable.
Yeah, but we're fighting centuries.
Don't forget that.
No, we have to take into consideration the cultural differences.
Do we? No, it's a crime to mutilate a little girl. In this country, you can't cut people up. Well, you shouldn't be able to take them out of the country and do it either.
It's going to take time. It's complicated culturally.
Let's stop poncing around with cultural differences. I don't care about causing offence.
That's not really what I meant.
No, it's barbaric. End of. Do you know how many prosecutions there's been in this country? None. Not one. How's that going to stop it?
No prosecutions.
None. And that's where poncing around gets you. I'll tell you what I think. I think that if you cut up a little girl and sew her back together again, it's got nothing to do with culture, it's got nothing to do with religion, it's abuse. Pure and simple. And any parent who's a part of that ought to burn in hell.
Oi, you. Am I going on my own?
Yeah. Anyway, it's nice to meet you. They'll give you a call. Oh, try the sandwich shop. Tell them I sent you.
Then at work today. Apparently Zara reckons our dad's dead decent.
He is decent.
But he's a good bloke, like Saint Robert or something. More Gandhi than the Scourge of Crimson Skellies.
Why'd she say that then?
Must have been touched by his saintly glow.
Don't.
Don't what?
He is good. He's kind and he always looks after us and he's always stood up for us no matter what we did, even when we lied to him.
Is this about the steroids? Because that was a long time ago and you know I'm sorry. I thought I'd made it up to you. I thought...
I'm talking about me. I'm the liar, Jack. I'm a thief.
There's a video on this site, and I had to turn the sound down. How can anyone do that?
The women will become empowered. They'll realise that there's nothing in their faith sanctioning brutality.
But what about now, though?
Mr. Sasse?
Are you the doctor that helped my daughter?
We were just discussing brutality.
Mr. Sasse, I'm Dr. Carmichael. I'm Amanata's doctor. If you'd like to go through.
It was just a laugh at first. It took my mind off Mom after Christmas. I knew that it was stealing, but by then I couldn't stop it. I wanted to stop it.
Well, that's all right then.
Don't.
What? My sister's just told me she's a professional tea leaf, a one-woman crime spree, but it's not her fault because... Well, because what exactly? She's suffering from some kind of syndrome, kleptoitis.
It's not just about the shoplifting, though, is it?
What else?
I've told so many lies. And Mom and Dad stood up for me. And Ryan.
Ryan? Ryan knows.
That's why he got the sack before. For covering for me. I know. It's hateful. Everyone's gonna hate me. Ryan does. I bet you do too.
She wanted to stay at home and be a mother. I thought she loved Aminata.
I'm sure she does.
I brought them to England to get them away from the old ways. Be safe. Today I discovered that my wife...
You had no idea.
Mariama chose to dress like that. She wouldn't have a mobile phone. She liked to be traditional. When she said she was going to visit her mother's family, I thought... I was worried, but then I told myself that... Aminata would have a nice time. She said that if girls are not circumcised, they grow up to like sex too much, they become promiscuous, then they get HIV. She believed it. She said she did it for Aminata. She's Aminata's own mother, and yet she held her down. Mariama still believes she did the right thing. Look, I have to go and be with my daughter.
He didn't know. Oh, I thought I would never have said.
I don't suppose he heard.
But I hated him. I got it completely wrong.
No, you didn't. You made a good call. If you're going to get the permanent job here, you're going to have to learn when to hold back. But I've no doubt you will.
Hey, Zora. I'm making a donation to these people who are fighting against FGM. And I thought £10 each.
Put this in for me.
Oh, I'll put it on there?
Yeah.
Right, had enough of this place for one day. You ready?
I'm ready. Tomorrow is a new day. Okay?
Doctor.
Hello, is everything all right?
I couldn't leave it like it was. Jam tarts.
For me?
I didn't mean to upset you. I'm sorry I made you so angry.
You've got nothing to apologize for. I'm sorry I upset you. I was out of order.
You're having a bad day.
Some yobs threw a samosa at me on the way to work. Hit me in the head.
Then I went on about my samosas.
How are you to know?
Me and my big mouth.
No, it happens to me all the time. You know, people see me and they assume I'm either Indian or Pakistani. You just caught me on one of those days when I was well and truly sick of it.
Fancy being mistaken for an Indian or a Pakistani. You must really hate that.
I do, I really do.
Yes, what an absolutely awful thing to be mistaken for. Huh, fancy that. You must be afraid people think you smell. Is that why you don't eat ethnic food? All the garlic, the spices. Too smelly. How awful it must be for you.
Sorry, I didn't mean
to... Keep your apologies, you snivelling, tinted little man. I feel sorry for you. Feeble little white boy stuck inside that golden skin. Too stupid to see himself. Too stupid to be proud.
You don't understand.
I understand you completely. White on the inside, brown on the outside. Huh. There's a word for people like you.
I don't know what to do. What would you do?
Did you need that top? That's a yes, then.
I don't even know where to start trying to take it all back. I can't remember where I got half of it from.
Little shops run by someone too stretched to afford proper security?
No. Not always. Big shops, sometimes. I've told you it was about the buzz.
I'm ashamed of you.
Please don't.
You know what you gotta do, right?
What?
Look, you're my sister, and even if you are a light-fingered little cow, I'll stand by you.
If I could take it all back, I would.
Amy, wake up. We don't live in some American teen drama. You can't just take it back, get forgiven, go home and eat pie.
So what should I do?
Dad's put himself on the line for you. He stood up for you. He's been good and decent.
I know.
You can't let Dad end up looking like an idiot.
But I don't know what to do.
You do. And you have to do it soon, before it's too late. Think about Dad.
What?
You've got to come clean.
How can I?
How can you not?
They've set a trial date.
Right in the middle of my exams.
New client.
It's a lunch, actually. I've got a date.
Check this out.
You're all right with this, aren't you?
Don't worry about me. Got your own life. Off you go.
This is Magistrate's Court. It's very routine. You'll be fine, trust me.
It's a sad day for Elizabeth.